What's up, Average Dad fans? Welcome back to another video. And yes, it's true. I finally took the plunge and ordered the Huawei Mate X3. This will be my first Huawei device, I think ever, certainly since the whole Google app debacle. And I'm tentative. Not scared, but tentative. And this is where I need your help, all of your help, because this is fresh areas for me, new waters. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Ultimately, let's get into the video. So before I get into the video, I have to cover some housekeeping. As always, if you haven't already subscribed, please make sure you do. In this occasion, if you subscribe, you're going to see more videos on my first ever Huawei device. And it's not just any Huawei device, it's the Mate X3. In my opinion, and I've said it in my previous Vivo X Fold 2 videos, the Mate X3 has been the most intriguing foldable device possibly ever for me. From a hardware and I guess software perspective, software, again, I'll get into that, but hardware wise, 5x periscope zoom lens, thank goodness, 5mm thick, unfolded, 11mm thick, folded. This should be a super sleek and premium phone and weighing in at less than an iPhone 14 Pro Max. Yeah, crazy, like 230 grams or something. But anyway, housekeeping wise, on my previous Vivo X Fold 2 full review video, I did say that I was selling it. Well, it'll come as no surprise, I sold it within 3 minutes. A subscriber had scrubbed through the video, got to the part where I said I was selling it, DM'd me on Instagram and purchased. And to make things even easier, subscriber lives local, so I don't have to ship it anywhere. They have purchased this Vivo X Fold 2. Congratulations, you know who you are. So where I need your assistance and help is in my comment section. If you are an owner of a modern Huawei device from like P30 onwards, essentially since the Google fiasco, how do you use your phone? I've seen something called Lighthouse and BotBox, iBot. I don't even know. That's how new I am. And I'm actually deliberately not watching any YouTube videos on it because I want to turn the tables on you. You have been asking me hundreds, if not thousands of questions to this point on the Vivo X Fold and Chinese ROM devices. Well, now it's your turn. Subscribers, viewers, commentators, let me know what I should do with my Huawei. What should I download? How can I get Google Apps? Can I get Google Apps? Is there other apps I should be downloading for it? What's the best way to set up my Huawei device? Now, as you can see, I've ordered the global release version as well, so I didn't go through Wanda, which, by the way, if you are going to purchase a Chinese ROM device, make sure you use my affiliate link in description for Wanda Mobile. I went to Huawei.com and they ship next working day, or it says 1 to 2 working days, but I've been reliably informed that my device should be here tomorrow. So that's a bonus. So obviously unboxing video to come, which by the way, I also haven't watched. I don't know what comes in the box. I'm hoping a case because I can't imagine getting cases is super easy for the Mate X3. It does come with a charger, which makes me think that the charger is either not in the box or the charger is like a Chinese charger that wouldn't work for me. It also, when I ordered, came with a Huawei GT3 watch. Never had one, but it's free, so I'll take it. And I guess, possibly most importantly, it comes with 6 month accidental screen protection, which, again, touch wood, foldable devices, I've yet to crack, break a screen, but it's nice to know that cover's included for free. So all in all, for all that, it was £1,999, which converts to about $2,500. A big purchase, but again, I said, if I can sell this phone, the money goes towards that. So the money for this pays for a good portion of the Mate X3. So, short video, just asking for your help, a call to action if you like, and while you're commentating, you know what to do. Hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already, and I will be in touch with numerous videos on the Huawei Mate X3, from software 100% to hardware and camera comparisons and full reviews, all that jazz. Until then,